Hello friends, this is SHAHBAZ and today we are going to explain about simple turning and circular operation. As you can see, this is our product and we have to make this one in CNC machine. So as I told you that before making in CNC, firstly we have to simulate in some software, and the software name is SSCNC simulation CNC software. So this product we have to make in CNC software. So what is dimension? As you can see, this is my 100, this diameter is a 100 diameter, this radius we have to make this one, this is my interpolation, circular interpolation, radius is 16th, here also 16th, and this is my 35. From starting point to this point is 36 and here 46. Understood? So let's start in CNC. So this is my software SSCNC. This is for simulate. So just click, double click. Now we have to choose this one, Sinomeric 802DT. Then go to run button. So click OK. Firstly, what we have to do, we know that we have to diameter, we have to take the product job having a diameter of 100, 100 diameter. So for taking the diameter or job, we have to go workpiece, okay, then stock size, then click stock size, then we have to give this diameter. As you can see, this is my diameter and this is our length, so no need to give the length, only we have to give the diameter. So the diameter was 100, but we have to give here 110, okay. Now click OK button. After taking the diameter or taking the job, now it's time to take a tool, that which tool is it is going to perform. So to select a tool, we have to go to machine operation, then tool management. As you can see, this is our tool management, click in this point. Now the list of tool has been opened, so select this one having an angle 35. Now select this tool turret, means position, first position means say spindle 3 jaw, 4 jaw or some other jaw, so there are some position, so we have to take a tool station 1, select it, then OK. After completing these things, now it's time to set machine coordinate system. So this is my machine coordinate system, so click at this point, click here. Now go to jog, click to this jog button, then click to this reference button. Now what will happen, see here X and Z having some coordinate in negative, so we have to put, we have to keep this one as 00. So go to this repeat button, click it. Now X, click X, now click Z, see 00 completed, okay. After giving this, again we have to go to machine operation. Why? To give a rapid position, we have to give, go to rapid position. So it's a rapid position, why? Because the machine, the tool will start at the center, from the center, okay, select at the center, then click OK. After giving this, now it's time to give WCS, which is stand for workpiece coordinate system. So click at this point, go to variant, this is my variant, click at this point. Now go to tool measure, click this, go to tool, sorry, firstly tool measure, then measure manual, then select set length 1, click set length 2, again set length 2, completed na, okay. Now go to back. So initially I have written a program for you, only I have to explain it. So to write a program, you can go directly program manager to write a program. If you want to write some program, then click new button, then you have to give some RAM, then okay. Initially I have written a program, circular interpolation, okay, this is my circular interpolation, this is our program. So open it, here's the option open, so click at this button, open. So now what we have to do, we have to make this point. Firstly what, see, firstly the tool, it is a solid part, we have to make this. So as you can see, the tool will be start here, the point is x0, at this point is x0 and z0. So our tool, as I told you in the earlier video, if you haven't watched my video, then you have to watch. Okay, see, initially it was in solid part. The tool we have to keep at some height, not say diameter is 100, so we don't have to keep the tool at the 100. No, because the tool will be break when the machine will be start. So we have to keep the tool at some height, so not to compensate. Okay, so the tool will start tool at some height. So initially, let's tell you about this program. See, G95 means feed per mm, means revolution, feed revolution per mm. G90 means absolute dimension, means starting from the same point, means starting point. Okay, G71, it's a coordinate we have to give in mm, millimeters. G71 means in millimeters. If G70, then G70 means in inches. So we have given a G71 millimeter. Okay, G00 means rapid interpolation, means point to point movement, X0, Z0 and D0. Then M06 is stand for M06 tool change, tool 1, D1. M03, it means spindle, it will start the spindle. Okay, after selecting all the things, the tool has arrangement. Now it's time to start the spindle. Spindle speed we have given 1000. Now starting Z00, X102, 102, Z0. What does it mean? See, as I told you that the tool will start not at this point. We have to keep at some height so that when the spindle will start, it will not directly touch on the tool. So we have to keep at some height. So initially I have given this, it is my X0, Z0. Now the tool come at this point at some height, 102 and Z0. So initially the tool is at this point. Okay, so second is Z01, X98, Z0, feed 0.1. Okay, so let's go in this point. Now Z01 means linear interpolation. Now when the spindle will start, our tool will start removing the material from the chop. Now Z01 linear interpolation, it will start. X98 means it has some feed, X98, then Z is still 0 and feed started. Now we have to move the tool from this point to up to this point, up to this point. Why? Because after this point, means after up to this point is linear interpolation, but after this there is a circular interpolation having some curve as you can see, but the radius is 16th and we have to keep only at this point. This is my total 36 and this is my radius. So what is the length of this point from here to here? 16th radius. So we have to minus 36 minus 16th, 20. So we have to keep, we have to move the tool up to 620. See, starting from X98, Z0, X98, Z minus 20. Then again we have to recall the tool at the same point. Now again we have to give some feed, means X90, feed 0.1, X90, then from 0 to minus 20, then again up to which point we have to give? Up to 35, means X should be 35. So 30 completed. Okay. Okay, this is my X35, Z0, again completed. So after this one, there is some point when the tool comes at this operation, there is some interpolation. This is my linear circular interpolation in clockwork direction. See, the tool will move at this point, it will start like this. So it is my clockwork direction, so it is called a circular interpolation in clockwork direction. So as a given, Z02, X67, Z minus 36, CR, circular radius is equal to 16th, then fit 0.1. See, Z02 is my circular interpolation. X, it's a coordinate, Z, it's a coordinate. As you can see, the tool is there and it moves up to this point. So what is the length up to minus 36 and what is the height? See, 16, then 16 lower, then plus 67. Okay, then when tool will come at this point, then it should, the tool should be moved at this rotation, means counterclockwise. So we have to give, for counterclockwise, So for counterclockwise, as you can see, Z03 is for counterclockwise. Okay, X 100, Z minus 52, CR circular radius is 16th. What does this mean? Let's see here. What we have to move, the tool is at this point. Okay, the tool is at this point. We have to move the tool at this point only. So what is the height, means the radius, means the diameter is, only we have to give in X the diameter. The diameter is 100, so we have to give X 100. Now what is the position of Z up to this point? See, up to this point is 36 and here the radius is 16th. It means that from here to here it is 16th. So 36 then plus 16th, we have to give 52. Okay, understood? Then again Z00, X02, Z0, it will move upside. M05 to stop the spindle, M30 to complete the to finish the work. Then to execute it, let's see what will happen after this point. After complete the program, then go to execute button, click to execute button, then go to switch window. Okay, now before starting the operation, firstly we have to close the machine door. So close it. Now zoom it so that you can easily see what will happen. Some problem in rotation. Just a moment, there is some problem about the rotation. Okay, no problem. Okay, let's see what will happen. So to start the operation, what we have to do, we have to go to auto button, click auto. Now cycle is start, the operation will start. Okay, just start, click. As you can see, it is going. The machining operation has been completed, as you can see. So let's start one more. So if you want to see the operation again, then go to workpiece, go to stock size, then only we have to click OK. The next job will come. Then again we have to click, just a minute. Again we have to click auto, then click start button. The same operation will be started. Okay. See how fine it's moving. Completed now. Same job. Okay. Thanks for watching this video. And next tutorial I'm going to explain about the threading operation, which is very important in CNC. So thank you.